Okay guys, here's a quick mock-up build of the DIY Audio Deluxe 5-unit aluminium chassis. So, you have a look at the brackets here. They're approximately 1.6 mil thick. So here's the base plate. We can measure that too real quick. Once again, 1.6 millimeters or so. Base plate goes over here like so, and it bolts in here. There's screw holes down the side. Same on this side. That's how it sits with the on the plate. Here's the rear panel. Just carefully measure that. Don't just scratch the hell out of it. Let's go here, shall we? 3 mil. So that goes here and it screws in these four. Yeah. We'll get the front panel. Comes packed in cardboard. The back of it has holes for the fasteners. And that is ten mil thick, maybe a hair under. Basically, that just sits here. I'll just lean it there for the second. And if you have a look, that's how the chassis is going to end up looking. So you can notice there's quite a, if I bring this flush, there's a decent gap there for wiring and the like, and the same goes for at the back. You've got a bit of a gap to play around with. Here's all the universal mounting specification holes in there for bolting your electronics to, and you can see the cutouts on the back panel for the speaker terminals and RCA or balanced inputs. So here's the cover. I'm going to leave it in the plastic wrap for the minute until I'm ready to build. But basically, you know, it's just going to go in there like that. Lots of vents, you know, excuse the reflection of the plastic there. But you get the idea. They're a pretty good looking case. You know, I mentioned the feet, you know, there they are there. If it helps, I'll chuck the caliper on there really quickly. So, you know, I'm squashing the hell out of it there, but you get a rough idea of the height. So one other thing, the top and bottom panel, including plastic, they're also 3 millimeters. So yeah, also just to give you a very rough idea of what the handles look like, you can see they're quite solid aluminium, anodized. I'll chuck the caliper on there too. So 10 mil, just like the front panel. When they're on the case, they're going to be approximately here, and should end up looking quite nice. So they, you have to drill holes through the pre-marked back panel, and they're countersunk so that it will mount flush here. Okay, here's a little bit extra information about the perforated base. So I'm going to have a closer look here so you can see how it bolts in. And you can put a base plate underneath which makes it quite strong. And then under here, you have a little bit of a gap. Now, if I bring that out carefully, won't destroy everything. Turn it over. If you look here, you've got about just under 9 millimeters, close to 9 millimeters of space. So your toroid transformer bolt, you can drill a hole through one of these and it can fit sandwiched between the base and the heat sinks and your top or bottom panel. I hope that helps.